Maganda umaga po. Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Our gospel passage today has so many things to teach us. The first thing that personally I learned from this passage is that the whole world belongs to God. It is God who has created the whole world, including me and you. And God is the one who assigns us whatever we have, our talents, our skills, whatever we are, whoever we are, it is God who assigns us, who allows us to become what we have become. But one thing is very sure, there's going to be a time that God is going to reward each and every one of us for how we have worked well in this world. So one important thing that I learned from this passage is the reality of being contented. Be contented with your gift. Be contented with your skill and use your skill to do what God wants you to do. One thing that we must realize is that the more we become envious or jealous of other people, the more we make our lives miserable. So it is better to appreciate what you have, you know, to accept who you are and to see how you can improve yourself. Because the more we look at other people, the more we refuse to be contented with what we have, the more we lose our energy. Because the energy you're supposed to use to move further, to improve yourself, you use such energy to look at other people. I am not saying that it's not good to appreciate other people, but when we start to have jealousy in our hearts or start to have envy in our hearts, then that will be our undoing. Again, in religious matters, sometimes some people think that because they have been Christians for 50 years or 100 years, that it gives them more opportunity to inherit the kingdom. It is not so. The number of years you have been a Christian does not really matter. What matters is, have you been committed or did you become a Christian until the end? There's going to be only one reward, and that is salvation, that is eternal life. No other person is going to receive anything, and that is the meaning of paying those who worked for 12 hours the same thing with those who worked only for 2 or 1 hour. We all are going to receive only one reward, and that reward will be eternal life. And that is the meaning of all of them receiving the same wage. In this life, we are created in a unique way. We are all unique. So there's no need of comparing yourself with another person. That your age mate got married does not mean that you must get married. So if you rush into marriage, for instance, you may make mistake. That you see your age mate doing something, then you say you must do it. Life is not a race. So there's no need of complaining or comparing yourself with other people. Try to discover who you are and excel and blossom where you are planted. As you go out today, I pray for you that the grace of God may be with you, that you may appreciate who you are, be contented with who you are, and, you know, present yourself to Jesus and present yourself to God, that He who has created you will bring out the best in you. God bless you.